eyes are receptive, my heart is open. My hands are receptive.
Because this is 1 year that heaven. Some of you may think, but God, when will you come through? You just entered that year. You just entered that year. 2016 is not your ordinary year. There will be extraordinary miracles for you in the name of Jesus. Stretch forth your hand to your pastor and your pastor, Mrs. One of the dangerous women in New York. I'm telling you, you have a dangerous first lady.
Yes,
and God will continue to expand you for me. I want to tell you that God is proud of you.
Yes.
And that's what matters. If God smiles at you, doesn't matter what the devil does, God nods his head.
Yes.
This year, my prayer, as we're going to pray for them, I don't want a man to boast or to just testify of me. I want God to testify yes, to the devil.
Yes.
Your greatest gift and blessing is when God starts boasting of you. He called the devil and said, come here, boy. I know you are wicked. Have you seen my servant? Follow me. I'm minding my own business. But hear me, when God begins to boast of you to demons,
yes.
This is one year that every tears will be wiped away.
Yes.
So it doesn't matter whatever the devil has done, stretch forth your hands toward them because they are carrying vision.
Yes.
I'm talking about things God may have been talking to them, helping thousands of people. Pray this one prayer point. Say, Father, more grace.
More grace.
You are not praying like COGA.
Father,
more grace.
More grace.
Begin to pray like you have never prayed before. More grace for your son. You already know what I'm here to talk about. Those of you who have the flyer and you have the magazine, the order of service, we will be going straight to the point. Deliverance. Deliverance from evil, negative thoughts. John 10:20. Put it on the screen. Let me clear. Everybody look at the screen before your Bible. Let's read it together and say, and I can't hear some people, and he has. And why? I'm talking about Jesus Christ. When you meet negative people, they will even call God possessed. No, look at Jesus was standing and said, we told you this guy, if you meet negative people, they can swear to their grave that they were born to suffer. You say, you don't know my village. You don't know where I came from. I swear. I was born like this. You are just talking. If I tell you my history, no, Jesus was preaching to death. They say he was mad. So even they call you names, turn into lemonade. No, they call Jesus man. I want to show you why they call him man. They say Jesus, you are man. If they stop there, I'll be happy. He has a demon. Jesus has a demon. Now, who will deliver him? In the midst of negative people, even God will be called possessed. You see the way how handsome you are like this? There are those who don't like it.
Yes.
It is your fresh face. I told him to do that. Looking 21. Why would you call Jesus a madman? When you surround yourself with negative people, like we read, the madness left for our culture in this modern day United States, that man needs to be arrested. He looked at the prophet. He said, even if God opened the windows of heaven, I will never believe people like this. And he said, the prophet didn't argue. He said, you will see. So it's not all the time you pray for your enemies to die. We're going to pray to the Lord. Give them long life to live long to see my manifestation. No, no, they will live long. They will live long to see what you become. They will live long to know that God is on your side. They will suicide because somebody told them they don't look good. Deliverance from negative thoughts. But before you deliver someone, that's why I started from here. Because negative people, everything Jesus did, they did not celebrate him. They ate his bread and were calling him names. They ate the fish. So we don't know how he's doing it, but I think he's a magician. But why eat his bread then? Ate and took some home. If you must become who God has designed you to become, you must swear tonight. Because God swear. All through the Bible, he swear. It's Abraham. Abraham. No, they don't come back. Abraham. I swear. What God do you need to swear before the people believe you? No, there are some negative people that need God to swear. This is 1 year that every devil around you will bow in the name of Jesus. You will do things you've never done before. I want your amen to begin the prayer for your deliverance right now. So hold your neighbor, may nobody take your place. Begin to pray, may nobody carry your blessing. May nobody take your anointing. May nobody hold that hand, Father. Whatever negative man, whatever negativity, whatever stupidity the enemy will use, there are things God will show you. There are things God will reveal to you. There are things God will give to you. It may not come the way you expected, but God is God. You don't tell him how to appear to you. You don't tell him what he needs to know. He already knows. I want you to pray. May nobody take your place. What God has designed for you to do, what God has designed for here, you think it's Satan giving you. Satan, I rebuke that idea. I lose myself. No, not everything is Satan. Deliverance from negative thoughts. I'm introducing that there are five arms needed for deliverance. But before we talk about the deliverance, how people look at your neighbor and say, are you still keeping some stinking thinking? Stinking thinking. Peter was an apostle, but he had a stinking thinking. He rejected what God. How many people are not married here? You may have been rejecting God's perfect man. God, I married this one like this. The day he spoke to you, look at the shoe that they don't know what this is. You are carried away by what your eyes can see. And men are not like women. They don't like to dress like women all the time. The man can be loaded and he will appear. There are people sitting here, they've seen Jesus, but they thought he was a beggar in New York City. Because he didn't appear the way you expect. And he will never appear like that. Isaiah was one of the most powerful prophets, my God. Mm. And God revealed to him 850 years before Jesus came. He said, when your Messiah will come, you will not recognize him. Because you'll be sitting on a donkey. And when he came, they didn't recognize him. First time Jesus was angry after his resurrection, man of God, he called his own disciples and said, you fool. No, I said, Jesus, I mean, that's so harsh. They said, you for 3.5 years I taught you. They were talking on the road. They said, he was not supposed to die. But we thought he had an object. But when he died, when he appeared to them, they said, hello. He said, hello, what is this? No, their master appeared. But because they were rooted and grounded in stinking thinking. There are many here who are begging, still walking when you are supposed to retire and start your own business.
Wow.
So if I leave this one now, the Bible says, and it's not Bible that puts it, the Bible says,
it's true.
The bed that hand is what fell in the bush. It's one of the amazement that I see when I go. At the age in which he started his business. In fact, there's a day they tweeted me on Twitter. They said, we would like you to follow Defams. I said, No, it was an email I got from Twitter. We recommend, you know how they recommend you to follow some people? It was a handsome Defams. These are impossible. No, Twitter asking me, we recommend you follow this guy. Yeah. You know, when you are told to follow, that means they've seen something you need to follow. When you meet people who have thinking that is negative, they will tell you you can't do enough. They will tell you God is only interested in ugly. Even when we all know, when David wrote that thou art made me, he said, you have designed me fearfully and wonderfully. At the age that I saw him already doing websites. What age did you start? 13. And then somebody is already 58 in New York and said, Lord, open my eyes. Open my eyes. Wow. No, with all the revelation. Oh, but at 13, he located just one gift. I want you to understand that this year, not one here, not one child, not one man, boy, girl, we will not waste this year in the name of Jesus Christ. God called Moses and he said, come, I want to use you. And Moses said, God, open your Bible. I've told you that I have demonstrated everywhere I go. He was telling God what God already knew. You know that I can no speak. You are sending me to Pharaoh to kill me. I said, Moses, what did you say? He said, I am telling you. If you want somebody, you can use. Look for somebody that can speak. Now, how many of you women here, a man will come and say, you will even wait for him to be saying, not yourself. After all the people he's here. So when God chose Moses, Moses was there. When you are stinking thinking, when negativity is planted in your spirit, you can't even see God. God now called him, Moses, you want to play? Let's play. I saw you with your big mouth before I found you in your mother's womb. You must go to Pharaoh. Grab your neighbor this year, you have no excuse. You have no excuse. Every negative thought, say with me, every negative thought. By the power of the Holy Ghost, I divorce you today.